Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, I'm a big fan of GoToSpecial. There's lots of cool things we can do with GoToSpecial. I always talk about using blanks or visible cells only. And while I was showing this in the seminar, someone said, well, hey, what does row differences do? And I have to admit, I never used row differences. It's actually pretty cool. We have a series of values here in A, the original values, and some values that we got back from someone else. They might have changed some of those values, and I need to see which ones changed. So I select the entire range, and you'll notice that column A is the active cell within this range. If I would press Enter, it would switch to another column, in this case column B. But I want column A to be the active cell, and we go to Edit, Go To, Special, and choose Row Differences. And what happens is anytime that column B or column C, D, E, or F, if that was included in my selection, is different then the active cell column, in this case A, it selects just those cells. So there's three cells here. Let me color them for you by hitting the paint bucket. Those are the cells that changed. Pretty cool, but rather limited, to be honest, because in real life you would have several columns, invoice, date, and amount, and another set with invoice, date, and amount, and you'd have to see if anything changed between the two of those. Well, if you actually wanted to do that, we'd have to build a concatenation formula to get A, B, and C into a single column. Well, let's take a look at this formula here. Basically, I'm taking A4, B4, and C4 and joining it all together with, in quotes, a semicolon. So that way, we see the three values with semicolons. I'll take this formula and copy it over next to my second data set. And I need these to now be adjacent to each other. So I'll use cut and paste to paste them into adjacent columns. We need to convert those formulas to values. Of course, several ways to do that. We can just use copy and then open the paste icon and choose paste values. Now, I have the two columns selected. You'll still see that the active cell is in the first column. So we'll go to go to and then special, choose row differences, and color those. You'll see that there are two rows where something from one data set to the other changed. We just need to go find these. So it's interesting. It looks really great when we just have two columns we need to compare. When you get to more columns, it kind of becomes convoluted. And really, why wouldn't we just build one formula to check to see if the concatenation of the left was equal to the concatenation of the right and be done with it? So it's an interesting option. In limited uses, it'll be pretty cool. When you get to several columns, which is really the real life case, it might be easier just to build a concatenation formula and check to see if those are equal or not. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.